I would like to get back home because the opposition is now preparing for the 1984 elections, and I'd like to contribute my efforts and my assistance to the opposition, having been the Secretary General of the major opposition party in my country. We need at least 4 months to reorganize our grassroots, and then maybe 4 months to campaign to be ready to be in shape for 1984.
Has there been an effort to stop you from coming back, and why would there have been this effort?
There has been tremendous effort to get me back. I mean, they denied my passport, they denied travel document, and I'm really puzzled why they would do that, because considering I have a death sentence, and considering that they have so many charges against me, I thought that they will welcome me back to make me face those charges. But then they brought me official communications asking me to delay my return by at least 1 month or maybe more, without any assurances that after 1 month I'll get a travel document. I don't know really why.
You have no idea why Marcos would not want you back?
I guess your guess is as good as mine. But I really want to get back to talk to the president. I feel that as long as I'm 10,000 miles away, I will not have the opportunity to talk to him. But if I'm in prison, if I'm his captive, I think he will condescend to talk to me, because I'd like to talk to him, really, to discuss some of the problems besetting our country, and maybe the opposition can help in the solution of those problems.
What do you expect to happen when we get to Manila?
I don't know. I have been reading in the press reports that they will put me back in a plane, in this same plane, and send me back to my port of embarkation. But I don't know how they can do that, because I'm a Filipino and I've lost my passport. I have no visa to Taipei, so I don't know how they can send me back. I really hope that they will allow me to stay in my country. It's my homeland. I don't mind if they put me back in jail. I have a death sentence, and in fact I'm coming back to tell them if they think I'm guilty, I'm ready to be shot. But if not, I would like them to free me so that I can discharge my duties for the opposition.
What is the connection between your going back now and President Reagan visiting the Philippines in a few months' time?
I think it's pure coincidence, because when I planned my return to the Philippines, President Reagan has not even announced his visit, so that it was just plain timing. I repeat, my fellowship ended 30 June, and I had to clear out of America. Otherwise, I'll have to get another fellowship for a year, and that will mean that I won't be able to come back until about June of 1984. So, the visit of President Reagan was really coincidental, I think.
What are your own political ambitions?
I've said time and again that I no longer crave for office, but I feel that I have a duty to discharge for my party and my colleagues, and I will just help in the rebuilding of our grassroots organization. I am humbled with a lot of legal cases, and I feel that history has really passed us by. And it's time for us now to help the younger elements of the party for leadership.
Can you be effective in organizing the political situation in the Philippines if you're behind bars?
Yes, it will be very limited, but better than none. I can be more effective in the Philippines than in America, 10,000 miles away, so that even if I'm in prison, as I did in 1978, I will be able to meet with my lawyers, who in turn will be able to pass on the messages to the grassroots worker. But the fact alone that I'm in the Philippines means a lot, you know, psychologically and morally for our followers. I don't think a general should be 10,000 miles away from the battle. He should be leading his troops, even if he should lead them from prison.
Why do you think that President Marcos has been so much opposed to you over the years and considers you to be so much of a threat?
I don't know. There's really an age gap between me and the president. I am 50 and he's 66, and I suppose it's just like an older brother not understanding a younger brother. But we have had no personal differences. He's been with the Nacionalista Party when I switched to the Liberal Party, and I really don't know. I only hope that he'll give me a chance to talk to him when I get back, and hopefully convince him on some things that I'd like to see happen in our country. I would like to reiterate, I am not out to overthrow him. On the contrary, I submit that I could be his best friend, because the opposition can be of help in restoring democracy in my country. And that's all we're asking for.
What, very simply, do you think that he should be doing he's not doing now?
I feel that he should now prepare the country for the time when he will pass away. And therefore, I'd like to see the beginnings of freedom of the press. Then after that, we should have free, clean, and honest election, credible election. And then we can go into restructuring the economy to help the poor, because the final bottom line thing here is, how well is the government helping the majority of the impoverished Filipinos? We have to address ourselves to the problem of the worker, the rural worker, the industrial worker, the very poor in my country. So that when you go to Southeast Asia, Taiwan, is, for example, is an example. It has progressed tremendously. Korea, Hong Kong, Singapore. And I see no reason why the Philippines cannot duplicate that. So I do believe that there is a tremendous room for improvement. And I think if the president will give the opposition a chance to contribute its input, the Philippines can move forward.
Now, the government has said that they have denied you travel documents because it's not safe for you to come back, that you would be possibly the victim of an assassination attempt. Is there a danger, a physical danger to you in going back?
I suppose there's a physical danger because, assassination is part of public service. Look at poor President Reagan. He got shot because Hinckley fell in love with Jodie Foster. So that's part of the hazard of the game. My feeling is we all have to die sometime. Now, if it's my fate to die by an assassin's bullet, so be it. But I cannot be petrified by inaction or fear of assassination and therefore stay in a corner. I have to suffer with my people. I have to lead them because of the responsibility given to me by our people. I think I'll get arrested immediately. Now, I am hoping that they will allow the press in Manila at least to talk to me. And therefore, I'll make my appeal to President Marcos directly through the local press. But I'm willing to go back to jail. I've asked them for no. So I'm prepared for that.
You're prepared to stay in jail then for his...
Oh, yeah, that's what they want. I mean, I can go two ways. I can go on an armed struggle, which I think is futile, or I can go to jail and continue my crusade from jail. And I don't think that jail has been an honorable place. So there's nothing to be ashamed of. It's an inconvenience, but it's something that I've lived with for ages. I've been very supportive and very sympathetic. So those 3 good years are the best years of my life. What, 12 years or 17 years? Karamanlis was out for 9 years. De Gaulle was out of France for some length of time. Khomeini was out for 18 years. I really don't know. But thanks to Mr. Marcos and his press, it's a negative press, of course, but they kept me alive. I mean, you know, they always headlined me as being mastermind of this and that. So I think, by and large,
in terms of the people that might be meeting,
the barricades and security are on. I think the very fact alone that we can land is victory enough. Everything after that's bonus. I mean, whether they put me back in a plane and ship me out or bring me to prison, I promise to return. I have returned against all odds. So that's good enough for me.